Hello, my dear friends. Good morning and good evening. A warm welcome to one and all of you, and it's my pleasure to welcome you to this online session where we are already in the business of dealing with multiple topics, and it gives me a great pleasure to once again say hello to you. Thank you for giving me the privilege to say hello to you again through this different session. All right. As a start, I would definitely say that these are the sessions where we are definitely dealing with certain important nomenclatures, aspects which helps you to improve in life, get into a lot of positivity, and therefore you don't lose attention over a period of time towards your goal, towards your destiny, towards your objective. And in the journey of your life, we don't want you to get defocused. And that's why these kind of sessions are very, very important for you to understand why it is necessary to walk a consistent life. And everyone wants to walk consistently in their lives without a doubt, but then they're not able to do it for various reasons. And that's exactly what we are discussing in every single session. Warm welcome again, and let's get into the topic of today's session. And the topic is bitterness. In other words, if I have to frame it into a kind of a sentence or a question, I would say, how does one get into bitterness? It's kind of a question which leads you towards leads you towards the analytical point, right? This is an analytical question where you really need to ask this question and analyze as what leads you into bitterness. Who is leading you into bitterness, and what is leading you into bitterness are the two different aspects which we need to analyze and understand. Okay. Now, without wasting any time, what is the definition of bitterness? Bitterness can make you feel worse than even an anger. It's very dangerous. The extreme, supreme form of anger is called as bitterness, because it involves not only the angry feeling, but also it makes you feel absolutely helpless. There is no way that I'm going to come out of this situation. Have you ever felt like that? Inside of you will be having that feeling, right? There is nothing that can help me fix this problem. And that's where most of the people make wrong decisions, even to the extent of ending their lives. And that's why this bitterness must be handled with due diligence and care, right? It is also referred to as embitterment in psychological standards, right? Bitterness happens when you feel there is no action left to take, because everything is out of control. You don't feel that you have any control at all, and because of those reasons you tend to get into some sort of decisions, and those happens to be the wrong decisions. When you're not in control, how will the nature of the decision be, right? So what causes a person to become bitter? These are the simple nomenclatures from human perspective: regrets, embarrassment, shame, or shameful experiences where they had been involved, that they have gone through, or guilt conscious, right? I shouldn't have done this, I shouldn't have done this. Many people keep telling this, right? Repeating it time and again. You know, from a single mistake, it can even haunt a person or taunt a person for years together, decades together. They continue to live in darkness. They continue to live in this kind of deprived mindset. And the ensuing negative thoughts, stress, and pessimistic outlook can create a dynamic in which you view the world in a bitter way, right? It creates certain dynamics in your mind that everything and anything, even good people, they will sound a little bitter to you. All because you feel that you are unworthy of, you know, feeling okay. And that's why we definitely want to touch upon this topic. Okay. Now, is bitterness a kind of a mental illness? Is it a disease? Right? A big scholar, medical scholar, says Roche wants that in this form, right? He wants something like this: staying bitter is a health risk leading to biological dysregulation and physical disease. Yes, it is a sickness, it is a disease. As how you treat cold and allergy, taking some pills, anti-allergens, or some infections with antibiotics, you need to treat this illness. And one expert has proposed that bitterness be recognized as a mental illness. and categorized as post-traumatic or embitterment disorder. They call it as PTED. Many medical people will understand. What that actually means is it's a pathological reaction to drastic changes in the life, events of life. The trigger is an extraordinary through common negativity that you go through various incidents or events in life. For example, divorce, bereavement, right? You're so overwhelmed with sorrow. In pandemic situation, many near dear ones are gone. And I also have lost few of my relatives, very known, very close to me. And I had to go through that depression for some time. And it took me a lot of time to overcome that, right? Dismissal and personal insult, for example, or whatever reasons, right? You are getting into this PTED state and all of us go through it, but you have ways to overcome. Now, somebody asks us an important thing, right? What are the signs that I could recognize that I have bitterness in my heart or bitterness within me? Or am I supposed to call myself as a bitter person or not? What makes me to recognize, help to realize? These are some of the characteristic features where you can classify yourself, whether you are in the bitterness category or non-bitterness category, right? They generally generalize. To them, everything, it's like generalized mode. They won't feel any difference in terms of emotions. You just go and convey them a happy news, they will look like this. Yeah, you convey the sad news, then also they will look like this. You will not be able to make out whether the person is sad or happy. And they hold grudges in their heart. They won't let go so easily. Is that your character? You know the truth. You cannot judge the other person, but you can judge yourself, right? And they like the sound of their own voice. What is that called? As sympathy, self-sympathy. They will always be self-sympathy, in self-sympathy mode. Oh, I'm so deprived. There is no one like me in this entire world. This is how they conclude things. And the next thing is they are very jealous. They just cannot take the growth pattern of a person who's growing at a faster pace. For example, the neighbor getting a better car. They just cannot take it in. Sleepless nights they will go through. And they make no changes in life. Some people you will see 10 years ago, however the way they were, after 10 years also you will see they are in the same way. Right? They struggle to accept advice. In fact, you can never go and offer them any advice. Don't advise me. This is how they will, you know, chase you back. They don't like advices. And they don't like cheerful people. They hate jokes. They hate sense of humor. You can never make them laugh because why? They hate it. And they can never be part of such events and all that, right? They will always shy away. Who are such people? They are bitter people. They have a problem. Mix of anger and also helplessness equal to bitterness. Now, what are the effects of bitterness? The latest research to give credence to the link between the state of mind and health is a recent study from Concordia University, right? They're like Stanford, that has found constant bitterness can make a person ill. Holding on to bitterness can affect metabolism. Immune system can get weakened, and those people become the prey in the pandemic situation. Yeah, an immune response to organ functions and leads to various physical diseases, infections. Researchers say lots and lots of impact could keep happening, right? And not just that, we have also got other studies. So if you are involved in one or more than these habitual practices, which I'm going to line up now, that also is another set of indications. See, earlier we found what is the checklist. We gave you a basic checklist. Now I'm going to give you a detailed checklist, which will help you to analyze and understand whether you are falling under the bitter category or not. Number one is you will not be able to forgive others that easily. In fact, no let go aspect. Forgiveness, no. Because why? You are always in that self-judgmental mode that you are right, others are wrong. You can be only right. Others can nowhere get close to your righteous deeds. You're so self-righteous. You're operating according to your law book, and no one can even refer that law book. At least you share your law book, no, and educate a little bit. You know, these are my likes and dislikes. At least they will be able to understand. You will also not show your law book or rule book, but you will start judging people. Who are you? You are a person who is so unforgiving in nature. Why? Because you always like to get that attention, right? And second aspect is very important. You will not forgive yourself. See, you commit a mistake, right? You will not be able to forgive. How is it possible for me to do that? How is it possible? How is it possible? They become like one psycho, you know, nuts loosened. Nobody. See, mistake happens with every one of us. and you need to let go of the mistakes and learn from the mistakes, and therefore you don't have to repeat it again, right? That's the best thing what any human being could do, because we are all not perfect human beings. We are pressing hard towards perfection. That's why these sessions are helpful, right? We are not yet perfect, but we are pressing hard. But until then, you need to forgive yourself and then move on. Only then you can move on. If you don't forgive yourself, you don't forgive others, it's like hindrance, it's like a blocker. Yeah, you will find that iceberg always coming towards you, and then you will have to block, or you will have to find a way to escape. But the iceberg is hitting you all the time, or it's a blocker, you're not able to sail through, else you will crash and die, isn't it? The next is like holding others to a higher standard than, you know, holding yourself. Always you will have that inferiority complex, about which we discussed in a different session. You will always feel little inferior, and because that will lead you, and that will again lead you to disappointment, annoyance, shakes your self-confidence, so many other consequences will fall, and therefore you will not be able to progress forward. You will always see that you are in the same position, or you are somewhere even backward. You will start marching backward. This kind of attitude emerges not only as a blocker to march forward, but it will take you backward. Why? Because the world will march forward, you will stand in the same position. Therefore, naturally, you will feel stagnant, and also you are backward because others are marching forward. You will feel you are left out. You will get into more disappointment and annoyance. Believing that things will never get better. These kind of people, no, they will never have that hope. Yeah, they will have no self-confidence. They will have no hope. Hopelessness and lack of self-confidence will be their important and key attributes. They will love it. How much ever you try to tell them, hey, don't worry, man, have some hope. Definitely things will change. And you give examples. See, in my life also it happened. They will never listen. Because why? They are bitter. They are blindfolded in bitterness. And therefore they are not able to listen. And nextly, believing that they have less control over their lives than they really do. All of us must believe this, that you have control over your life. If you don't have that belief, then already you have lost your life. It's as good as like you are dead and gone, right? You're like that mortal body buried in the graveyard already. Never ever lose that hope, believing that you just cannot do it. You can do it. You try differently. You try a different thing. You discover what is your interest and what can make you successful. That's life, right? And the next is like, they don't have gratitude. They don't have attitude to thanks. That will be my last list, right? Anything you do to them, good. I mean, the best things, or the best of the costly clothing, or you even give them the Audi car, they will still say, no, I don't want it. They will have that ego. Some reason, and they can't explain it, why they don't want it. Why you don't want, man? You were asking, right? You said that you love Audi car. Maybe 5 years ago, I heard you saying you like Mercedes-Benz, and here is the gift. Take it. Enjoy. They won't. No, I don't accept gifts. Something like that. I've seen many people in my life. Okay. So if you are in this category, then please. Because why? There is no specific reason for this bitterness in your heart. That's exactly my point. Right? You will not be able to discover or rediscover. Yeah, because it's a mix of anger and mix of hopelessness, mix of helplessness, slapping it together, and you built a mortar, cream of mortar. Mortar is a gluing agent, but this mortar will not glue. It will separate things. You will be separated from your soul, your own self. You will be separated from the world. You will be separated from relationships. You will not have any friends. You will only embrace loneliness, disappointment, annoyance. What kind of life is this? Think through it. You're already living this life? Then yes, we have some tips and steps to overcome. With that, we will close. I hope you have understood so far what we are trying to say. The first thing is like, conduct a serious reevaluation with an open mindset. You be honest to yourself that you have these five top problems, and which is the reason for bitterness, which is the reason for ego, which is the reason for you being judgmental. You are not able to forgive anybody for these reasons. You need to reevaluate, conduct some self-evaluation, have a journal, note it down, and try to evaluate, right? Put all your assumptions and stories. You have some mythology, you have some fairy tales in your head, right? And 9 out of 10 fairy tales are only your assumptions. You're living in a dream. You're living in assumptions. You need to go and reevaluate. That's why I told you, reevaluate. and put until then all your stories in your head on hold. You go on a shopping spree and you find out exactly what happens, or on a hunting spree. You hunt out the true reason. And the third important aspect is take whatever responsibility you can. For example, you know, many people who are bitter, right? They always have the blaming attitude. They will throw it, pass it on to somebody. This guy, no, he only misled me. This girl, no, she only told me. She told, but where you sold your brains, or you have given your brains for some overhauling? No, right? It was your decisions. And everyone will tell some or other things, whatever they like, because we are living in democratic world, and anybody can, social world, and anybody can even jab something in the Facebook or Twitter, and whatever they say, you do it, and then you end up in a failure, and then you blame them. You only told me, no. You have that attitude, no? You have a problem, come out of it. The best way to come out of it, take responsibility for what you are doing. Ultimately, it's your decision, right? You are influenced, but it's your decision, right? Therefore, you need to take responsibility for what you are. If you start standing strong in these kind of parameters and aspect, then you are no more going to live in bitterness. Trust me, right? Stop spying. The fourth important aspect is spying, right? They won't believe. Doubtful attitude. Anything and everything. They will doubt their wives, and the wives will doubt their husbands if they are living in bitterness, either of them. Or they will doubt their friends, and they will again call up that friend. Hey, he told me something like that. Is this really true? Did you hear? Like, they will re-clarify that. But obviously, you should be very sure. That person will call and inform. Hey, you know what? That guy called, actually. He clarified whether you told like this or not. If that person hears, will he trust you the next time? You lost the relationship. So spying, never ever think, will not come out. It will get leaked at the same moment, especially when you put the disclaimer, hey, don't tell this to anyone, huh? You, and then you, you know, keep the phone. That is the disclaimer that they will spread it all the more. Just try doing that. No, don't tell this to anybody. You say, you tell this and keep the phone. That will spread faster. So please stop that spying attitude and disbelief and all that. Have some little trust. If you have decided to get along with someone, right? Fifthly, face up the hidden fears. Have the courage to face the fears of your life. If you don't have the courage to face the fears, you will live in fear and you will die in fear. You don't want to do that, because that's just such a miserable experience, horrible and horrifying experience. One could live in fear and panic and paranoid. And no, this is not the way how you should live your life. You should live joyfully. You should live happily. Right? You should live in courage. You should have the boldness to face the fear. Yes, you failed a couple of times, but the third time you may not fail, and fourth time you will not fail. You would have found your ways to overcome that mistake, and that's how every one of us are living as successful people. You know, they have gone through failures, and now they made the decision to face that fear, face that failure boldly. Sixthly, easy thing: forgive people. Why? Because you are not perfect. You don't think you are God and you are supernatural and all that. Everything you do is definitely going to be yes and amen or yes and successful and all that. Definitely don't have that kind of self-prejudice. I would have not committed such a mistake. Have you heard people? If it was me, no. I would have done it differently. Is it? You have not gone through the situation, and that's why you are judging. Had you gone through the situation, you would have done even more a terrible thing than that guy or a girl. So never judge anybody. Forgive, let them go. And don't forget to forgive yourself. That's another aspect. It's all part of the previous point. The next point is you step into the present. Don't think too much on the past. Don't think too much on the future. Focus on the present. You need to have planning for the future. I'm not against it. Have targets, have goals, objectives. But focus on the current happenstance. That's good enough. Good enough to focus on the worries of the day. Because why? We are living in such a rapid world. We are at a fast pace. And you think, overthink, and you focus too much on the future. What will be my career in 6 months from now? Let's see after 6 months. You are working on a target, right? Just focus on that. Your career will all be fine. If it is not fine, you rediscover after 6 months. And then you have a plan for another 6 months. And last couple of things. Like, try new perspectives. Be very, very dynamic to experiment new things. That's when you learn. That's when you build your courage. That's when you build your confidence. That's when you replenish your heart, mind, and spirit and body with full of energy, new energy, right? Else you will feel so sluggish, right? Last but not the least, with that we will close. Please seek support. Support could be your friend. Support could be your parent. Support could be your own wife, your own husband. nothing wrong. You can even consult your children. Children are very smart, I'll tell you. They'll get brilliant ideas. Never say, she is my children, only 15 years old, how can I ask? 10 year old, how can I ask? 10 year old is, I will tell you, these days 10 year old is equivalent to 40 year old. They know everything. So don't ignore anything, any consultation or any help from or any support from any source. Consult the medical doctors, go through some basic medications, nothing wrong, but overcome bitterness. All right, with this we would like to conclude this session, and please leave feedback and let us know if you need any new topics, and we will definitely try our best. And please comment in the YouTube channel and subscribe yourself, and also share it with your friends and relatives, and be an instrumental in spreading this positivity, the positive message. God bless you. Take care. And these are pandemic situations. Please don't try anything or experiment anything outside. You will get into trouble.